Brittany Diorio is, I guess, now a former teacher in Barrington, a special ed teacher, who lost her job because she did not want to get vaccinated. And you know, it's a tragedy because that is a completely ridiculous requirement, but also because we're in such desperate need of special ed teachers. So.
Thank you, Dr. Boston. Good evening. My name is Brittany Diorio, and I was a Barrington school teacher whose employment was terminated for not getting the COVID vaccine when they mandated it in the fall of 2021. Noted this week on April 18th, the emergency use authorizations for the vaccines we refused to take and for which we were fired were just withdrawn by the FDA. I have spent the better part of my life caring for and educating children in a variety of settings, including 14 years as a professional educator in the state of Rhode Island. I have poured my blood, sweat, and tears into the teaching profession because I believe it is my God-given calling to make a difference in the lives of what we most cherish, our children. I gave up a 13-year teaching position and tenure in Pawtucket to join the Barrington Public Schools in 2020. I have a bachelor's degree with a double major in early childhood education and special education. And additionally, I was in the state's first cohort of 30 teachers from two school districts to become certified and earn my master's degree in TESOL, which is teaching English to speakers of other languages as well as dual language immersion from the University of Rhode Island. Like so many young families, my husband and I rely on two salaries to pay our bills. I held the medical coverage for our family, and at the time we had a 9-year-old and a 6-year-old both attending Barrington Public Schools. Both my husband and I are lifelong residents of Barrington. The impact of losing my job was immediate, profound, and lifelong, not only financially because of loss of income and health insurance, but emotionally and physically due to the extreme and sudden nature of the stress. The Barrington School Committee, the administrators, and legal counsel's decision forced us into an ongoing legal battle, and they've continued to dig their heels in to try and prove that they are right. Barrington could have allowed us to work like the 21,000 other educators in the state of Rhode Island that did not lose their job over this shot. They could have done what the other 38 other Rhode Island districts did to continue using safety protocols, which had been used for 15 months prior. But Barrington suddenly decided these protocols were no longer safe and effective. They could have taken the recommendations of RIDO and RIDE that also stated following protocols would allow teachers to work safely with students. Again, Barrington disregarded these recommendations. Barrington could have hired us back when the healthcare professionals were allowed to return to their jobs, caring for high-risk patients in hospitals and nursing homes, but we remained unemployed, struggling to support our families. The union that we had paid dues into for years could have supported us and stood up for us, but instead said, in quote, "The district is following protocol and the law in how they are proceeding, and there's nothing more we can do for you in this situation other than to counsel you to receive the vaccine or look for employment elsewhere." Eventually, the NEA admitted, although too late, that, in quote, "termination would be a death knell to these teachers' careers." Barrington disregarded NEA's advice and terminated us regardless. Mr. Missouri, the superintendent of Barrington Public Schools, could have honored his word, saying, in quote, "We are not terminating teachers, and there is no need to worry. You were provided with inaccurate information." This is in regards to a meeting I had with him after we were told we would be terminated. He said, "Look at number 2 of the signed MOA with the union. You will see the statement that says all unvaccinated staff must wear 2 masks or a KN95 mask, as well as being placed on a mandated testing schedule. Again, no need to worry, we're not firing teachers." The beginning of this 2022-2023 school year would have been my 15th year teaching. I could have never imagined that all my hard work, determination, and pure joy of teaching children would turn into being fired for insubordination, placed on unpaid leave, stripped of my livelihood as well as health insurance for my family, and battling in and out of the courts to defend my life's work in educating and caring for children is not something I thought I would be doing. Barrington could have chosen other options instead of unnecessarily targeting qualified teachers, assassinating our character, and ruining our reputations in the process. Thank you, and I appreciate Dr. Boston.